Hey YouTube, it's Creepy Crawler. Hey, look around. Where are we at? We're at a hare scramble. And you can't hardly see it, but Rusty's back here. We're gonna go see what we can do.
We made it.
Here and see it in the background, but we're at the hare scramble. I think it might end up being just me and Sean in the pro class, but that's all right. We'll race each other and have a hell of a good time. So y'all might know who this is. If you don't know by this, you'll definitely know by this. Oh my God, look at this sexy fucking thing. Phew! It's gonna be a good day, boys.
All right, so I'm gonna try to narrate over this a little bit at the start of the race here. I'll jump it off the edge. Sean just pulled out a wake from both me and Roy. I just got a little better lane choice in there. Trying to get around him on the ride, it's just not happening. Trying to get the inside on him. Nope, he pulled the power wheeler there. It was awesome. Yeah. As you can see, we're getting lined up here, both rolling pretty good. But he's starting to lead on me, pull on me. I'm sliding back and forth pretty good. That is kind of hard to tell about being there, whatever, that track was slick as ice. Where we were, you know, the tires are flat, you see me kind of drifting there, sliding into berms. The flat, wet part where your tires are riding was like ice, and then the berm grabbed real hard. So here we come around. I think it's pretty soon here where a big chunk of mud gets up in the lens. Trying to do what I can. Let's see, he's just leaving me. Thing is awesome. Definitely huge shout out to Red ZZO too. That thing is just badass. Right here, obviously, big chunk of mud gets in the lens. I'm going to leave it rolling here for just this first full lap. Just so you guys can see the track in its entirety. It wasn't a real long track. They cut it down pretty good because it had been raining. I think it rained for like 2 days before that and rained the whole day of the event. Like it was drizzling on us as we're racing right here. This is where it starts to get interesting. So, we come around here, we're flying. I didn't realize why he was slowing down. I kind of bumped into him a little bit. And then the tractors were already stacked up, lap traffic, just something awful. So he sneaks through right here. I'm right on his tail. See, there's just people everywhere. Not hit somebody right there. I don't know what they were thinking. So Sean went left, I went right, just luck. Right line was a little clearer. I bounced around these people. Had to run pretty hard to pass him, and then I hit down in there, fell clear off the tractor. My hand. You can see it's just kind of mad chaos through this wood section because a lot of these tractors are stock. Oh, here you can see I'm giving this guy a hell of a ride. I wish you guys could see his eyes because they were pretty big around. I don't think he was expecting to take the ride with me, but he was blocking the trail and I needed to go, and he was just stuck, so figured I'd just push him one up to where I could get around him. Worked pretty good. Rusty just being a freaking tank. Let me skip forward here a little bit. Down here, coming into the beginning of the track again. Now kind of basically cut off the whole field section. And ripping up through the wood section again. It's a little more open at the bottom. Got to get around this guy. Come up here and make the pass. Tricky. Top flip again, now you can really see it. Come up to a big pile of lap traffic. Basically sneak around here. Bump into him a little bit. Not moving. He's going to run over. That's just hair scrambles. That's just cross country racing is what it is. There's Sean again. Sean got all kind of messed up. I was trying to get around, but I couldn't make it happen. Back a little bit so he can go. There we go. Snuck around. Almost ran them over, blasted through past them. Then I come up behind Roy here. I think this is a few laps into it at this point. I was in the lead, but I was coming around to lap both these guys. Don't think I got around Roy at this point. Roy gets up through here. Now here we're back around, skip through the field section, back into the woods. Roy's right behind me. It was like a snapper or something. The dude with the horn helmet. So there's a huge bottleneck. These kids are directing me over this way. Run over a grapevine. About run into these people. Couldn't hardly get on the brakes fast enough. And he had that way blocked. So Roy was behind me. Back up or whatever. And then about hit that kid again. So right here, this guy with the snapper thing throws it in reverse right as Roy's running around him. And I don't know, he probably just didn't. Smacks into Roy pretty good. Me and Roy both sneak back around him. And then it's bottleneck again. And Roy gets up around to the right, I believe. Yep. Come around this turn. And Roy is in second, I believe. He goes to get third. And bangs reverse. Bang. I bump into him there a little bit. And get ripping back out on the straightaway here. I clip this Cub Cadet and just about roll it. I mean, I come up in 2 years, you can't really see the video. Finally get the lens wiped off so you guys can see. This is in the wood section. You can see how much mud is on top of the rusted hood. It's just crazy. And then this was pretty cool, banging past these guys. That was just a lot of fun. Just kind of clipped the nose of both of them with rear tires. Sorry, fellas, if you're out there watching this, just, you know, it's just racing, nothing personal, just trying to make progress. Because I got Sean and Roy hot on my ass, so I can't be sitting and waiting.
Well, guys, that was one of the funnest things I've ever done on a tractor. Sure, you just seen. Sorry, the GoPro footage is so rough, but it was so muddy. I could barely stay on the tractor. You can see me fall off of it a couple times if you look close. I did go ahead and run most of it, even though it had a big chunk of mud on it, because you can still see some stuff. I know the video sucks. I'm sorry. Did the best I could. I could barely stay on the tractor. I did reach up and wipe the GoPro once, but about as soon as I wiped it, it got another big chunk of mud on it. We'll take you over and talk a little bit more about it. So this is after I scraped probably solid 2 inches of mud off the top of the hood. Honestly can't believe this thing didn't overheat. There was mud all packed in the air stuff here. The air filter did pretty good, got a little bit on the outside. I scraped these out. These were completely full up to here. There was a solid 4 inches of mud on the rear fenders. They were hanging down so much they were almost on the tires when I pulled in. There's so much mud packed in around the shifter. It was up here. When I shifted, it would like push a whole bunch of mud off one side or the other. The throttle, my foot was up above it, and I thought the motor was getting softer, the belt was slipping, but what it was is I couldn't push down the throttle because there was so much mud and grass packed underneath it. I was only getting about half throttle. So to say this race was muddy is a complete understatement. You can see how much mud still packed everywhere. The Rusty was a freaking champ, man. I cannot believe this thing worked as good as it did. I was able to push a couple people up out of my way. The bumper worked out great. Just had a freaking blast. Well, that's pretty much it for me today. They're having another one of these races in September, they said. I'll get the details and try to put them up on Ohio Off-Road Mowers on Facebook. I might even do another video about it. Huge shout out to New East Coast Cross Country Series. That's the one who put this race on. I got a big sweet trophy from them. I wasn't expecting that at all for getting first place. The other guys, Sean and Roy, they kicked ass too. You can kind of see in the video. The main reason I won is I just got lucky when we hit lap traffic. Sean went left and I knew if I was behind him, I'd never pass him. So I went right and it just happened to be more open on the right side. And I was able to get ahead, and then he had a couple belt issues, so I was able to stay ahead. Roy, he was right there. I'm pretty sure he got around me when I was taking my chest protector off, and we battled back and forth, and he just happened to get a little wide on one turn, and he slid off the track just a bit, and that was just enough for me to get past him. Otherwise, I don't think I would have been able to get past him. He is fast. So, once again, had a freaking great time. If you get a chance to do this, man, I drove 3.5 hours, and it was worth every minute of it. Definitely get out there and try it out. But thanks for watching. Once again, sorry the video was so quality was so terrible on the GoPro stuff. And give me a thumbs up, give me a comment, let me know. Would you ever do something like this? Are we gonna see you at the next race? Let me see it. All right, Creepy Crawler out.